Yeah. Zero is a wonderful thing. In fact, Zero is my hero.
How can Zero be a hero?
Well, there are all kinds of heroes, you know. A man can get to be a hero for a famous battle he fought. Or by studying very hard and becoming a weightless astronaut. And then there are heroes of other sorts, like the heroes we know from watching sports. But a hero doesn't have to be a grown-up person, you know. A hero can be a very big dog who comes to your rescue, or a very little boy who's smart enough to know what to do. But let me tell you about my favorite hero. Did you ever stop to think about Zero? Zero is fantastic. Why, without the concept of zero, we'd never be able to multiply, divide, add, subtract, or even to count very high. My hero, Zero, such a funny little hero, but till you came along, we counted on our fingers and toes. Now you're here to stay, and nobody really knows how wonderful you are. Why, we could never reach a star without you, Zero, my hero, how wonderful you are.
What's so wonderful about a zero? It's nothing, isn't it?
Sure, it represents nothing alone. But place a zero after one, and you've got yourself a ten. See how important that is? When you run out of digits, you can start all over again. See how convenient that is? That's why with only 10 digits, including zero, you can count as high as you could ever go. Forever towards infinity. No one ever gets there, but you could try. With 10 billion zeros, from the cavemen till the heroes who invented you, they counted on their fingers and toes. And maybe some sticks and stones,
or rocks and bones,
and their neighbor's toes. You're here, and nobody really knows how wonderful you are. Why, we could never reach the star without you, Zero, my hero. Zero, how wonderful you are. Place 1 zero after any number, and you've multiplied that number by 10. See how easy that is? Place 2 zeros after any number, and you've multiplied that number by 100. See how simple that is? Place 3 zeros after any number, and you've multiplied that number by 1,000. Etc., etc., ad infinitum, ad astra, forever and ever. With zero, my hero, how wonderful you are. Days and 40 nights, didn't it rain, children? Not a speck of land in sight,
didn't it rain?
But Noah built the ark so tight, they sailed on, children. And when at last the waters receded, and the dove brought back the olive tree leaf, he landed that ship near Mount Ararat, and one of his children grabbed Noah's robe and said,
"Hey, Dad, how many animals on this old ark anyway, huh?"
"Elementary, my dear, 2 times 2 is 4. Elementary, my dear, 2 times 3 is 6. Elementary, my dear, 2 times 4 is 8. Elementary, my dear, 2 times 5 is 10. 2 times 1 is 2, of course, and it must occur to you, you get an even number every time you multiply by 2. Elementary, my dear, 2 times 6 is 12. Elementary, my dear, 2 times 7 is 14. Elementary, my dear, 2 times 8 is 16. Elementary, my dear, 2 times 9 is 18. 2 times 10 is 20. 11 twice is 22. Double 12, that's 24. 13 twice is 26. 14 twice is 28. 15 twice is 30. Now you build it up on 30. 16 twice is 32. Elementary. 17 twice is 34. Elementary. 18 twice is 36. Elementary. 19 twice is 38. Elementary. 20 twice is 40. And it must occur to you, you can double any number. All you do is multiply by 2. Elementary, my dear, 2 times 2 is 4. Woo.
Elementary, my dear. 2 times 3 is 6. Yeah. Elementary, my dear. 2 times 4 is 8. Whoop. Elementary, my dear. 2 times 5 is 10. Yeah. Now, if you want to multiply 2 times 174, or some big number like that, 2 times 174 equals 2 times 100 plus 2 times 70 plus 2 times 4. That's all. So 2 times 174 equals 200 plus 140 plus 8 are 348. It's elementary.
Elementary, elementary.
Twice 32 is 64.
Elementary.
Twice 33 is 66.
Elementary.
Twice 34 is 68.
Elementary.
Twice 35 is 70.
Elementary.
Yeah, yes, it's elementary. Yeah. Now, what's 2 times 98?
Oh, that's hard.
No, it's very simple. 2 times 98 equals 2 times 100 minus 2 times 2. That's 200 minus 4. 196. Elementary.
40 days and 40 nights, didn't it rain, children?
Three is a magic number. Yes, it is. It's a magic number. Somewhere in the ancient mystic trinity, you get three as a magic number. The past and the present and the future, faith and hope and charity, the heart and the brain and the body give you three as a magic number. It takes three legs to make a tripod or to make a table stand. It takes three wheels to make a vehicle called a tricycle. Every triangle has three corners. Every triangle has three sides. No more, no less. You don't have to guess. When it's three, you can see it's a magic number.
A man and a woman had a little baby. Yes, they did. They had three in the family. That's a magic number.
3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30.
3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30.
Now the multiples of 3 come up 3 times in each set of 10. In the first 10, you get 3, 6, 9, and in the teens 10, it's 12, 15, and 18. And in the 20s, you get a 21, 24, 27, and it comes out even on 30, yeah.
Now multiply backwards from 3 times 10.
3 times 10 is 30. 3 times 9 is
27.
3 times 8 is
24.
3 times 7 is
21.
3 times 6 is 18. 3 times 5 is 15. 3 times 4 is 12. And 3 times 3 is 9. And 3 times 2 is 6. And 3 times 1 is 3, of course.
Take the pattern once more. 3,
3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30.
Yeah.
30.
Now multiply from 10 backwards.
3 times 10 is 30. 30.
Going
3 times 9 is 27.
3 times 8 is 24.
3 times 7 is 21. 3 times 6 is 18. 3 times 5 is 15. 3 times 4 is 12. And 3 times 3 is 9. 3 times 2 is 6. Three times one.
What is it?
Three!
Yeah.
That's a magic number.
A man and a woman had a little baby. Yes, they did. They had three in the family. That's a magic number.
The four-legged zoo to visit our four-footed friends. Lions and tigers, cats and dogs, a goat and a cow and a couple of horses.
A rhinoceros. rhinoceros, and of course a hippopotamus, and oh yes, a horse.
There are elephant, bison, and new one too, giraffes and elephants, quite a few.
A llama, alpaca, vicuna, two zebras, ibexes, and one big kudu. It was swell.
I like the gazelle.
Now Miss Simpson said,
she teaches school, you know.
Yeah, she took us in.
Well, Miss Simpson said,
if you counted every head on these quadrupeds, then multiplied that number by four, we'd know how many feet went through the door if we turned them all loose.
Harlan, don't do that.
It's really a groovy zoo.
But anyway, what Miss Simpson said, it was a good chance to work on our fours and our head. One, two, three, four.
I'll take a lion.
One times four.
He's got four legs and maybe a roar.
Give me two camels.
That's two times four.
Eight legs walking across the desert floor.
A tiger and a lamb and a fat kudu.
We have three times four equals four legs too.
But we might have to subtract when that tiger was through. Rawr! Four four-footed friends, no matter who, would have 16 legs, and it's always true.
That four times four equals 16. Five times four is 20.
Now a coach and six, if you were Cinderella, would have you home by midnight.
Ah!
If those 24 legs ran fast as light.
Six times four equals 24, and seven times four equals 28.
Anyone knows that who cares about seven?
And eight antelope have 32 legs, cause eight times four is 32.
Here come a small herd of buffalo. They say they're getting extinct, you know.
I can count nine, that's 36 legs.
Nine times four equals 36.
Here comes a baby buffalo.
That's good, that's 10. And 10 times four, you know, is 40. 11 coyotes.
11 times four.
Went slinking over the prairie floor on all of their legs.
Equals 44.
Now 12 times 4 is as high as we go.
12 times 4 equals 48.
But there were so very, very many, many more animals standing there by the gate.
And we'd have to use a pencil if we counted them all. And we really had fun and we saw everyone.
A bear, a cougar, a jackal, a yak, a fox,
a deer, a sweet giraffe.
And I can't remember how many, many more, but we multiplied them all by four.
And some of them thanked us with a roar.